About a month ago, I made a video talking about the top 10 reasons why you should buy this GA-2000 watch. Watch it if you haven't yet. If you scroll down to the comment section, I did ask you guys to list down your reason not to buy this G-Shock watch, and in this video I'm gonna compile down all 20 reasons. We have a lot to cover, so I'm gonna be really fast. At number one, there are no button guard in the watch, which is great for a carbon core model, but that is a downside. Since it has no button guard, you could accidentally press the button as you bend your wrist, especially if you're wearing long sleeve and a glove. At number two, this watch has double LED lights separately, which is great, but it didn't have any auto light functions at all, which I found really inconvenient. I love auto light on a G-Shock watch. Number three, this watch has a lot of features like countdown timer and stopwatch and alarm, but the timer didn't have any auto repeat feature, which could come in inconvenient to some of you guys. For me, I'm good. At number four, this watch has 5 alarm including signal, but it didn't have any snooze alarm built in. So if you need that feature, this watch aren't for you. At number 5, this watch is blackout white watch face, but it didn't have any solar panel at all, meaning you're gonna consume a lot of battery. But for the price, well, I could agree, but hey, no solar panel. At number 6, despite having large 3D index around it, and also color as well on top, but those just paint, not luminescence at all, which is a bummer. I really love luminescence on a G-Shock watch as well. At number 7, for an analog digital G-Shock watch, it would be nice to have a moving second hand. In this case, you only gonna need to rely on the digital display only for the seconds counter. At number 8, one of the big advantages of this watch is that it has this interchangeable strap, and Casio even gave us a lot of straps to replace, but the adapter or the lug of the watch only came in resin, meaning each time you swap the watch band, you're gonna end up scratching the part, and since it didn't have a lot of protection, it is a bit concerning if whether it will break over time or not. Not sure about that, but it is a little bit concerning. Number 9. This watch has a large watch face for the analog, but a really tiny digital display, especially in this 3 o'clock position, one of the most important parts, where it will display us the date, day and time. But it is so tiny. It is too tiny for a watch this big. At number 10, since this watch is fully resin, not a problem, most G-Shock watch is resin, but I gotta say, I already got a few scratches on the back plate already, and unlike metal, this part's pretty hard to polish and you cannot remove it, so quite permanent. At number 11, the screw at the front of this bezel, depending on the colorway that you pick, is a little bit flashy for a matte out black look, which is okay for me, but I'm not sure for some of you guys. At number 12, is not applicable to me at all. One of you guys comment that since this watch is totally black out, especially if you put this black strap, he got mistaken for an infantry just because of the look and appearance of the person. And I'm not sure that's a good thing or a bad thing, but something to think about as well. If you want people to perceive you differently, avoid this colorway, pick another one. At number 13, the resin on this watch band is thick, I believe the thickest, which is great, but it is not as comfortable as comparison to other square G-Shock watch or on the lower end size. Because they did use different material, it does feel a little bit plasticky. But for the price, I'm good, but for the feels, not so much. Not as comfortable as this cloth band at least. At number... Alright, we got a visitor right now. She's wanna play, just sit down there. Alright, play around. Okay, now where was I? At number 14, this G-Shock bezel has a lot of lettering. It has G-Shock, just mode and all those, but didn't have any protection lettering. Hey, this one is art for me, but one of you guys commented that it didn't have any protection lettering. So there it is. At number 15, from the disassembly video I made, replacing the parts gonna be pretty difficult, especially the bezel on top. It's pretty annoying, at least in comparison to replacing bezels on a traditional G-Shock watch like these fellas. At number 16, this is not an atomic watch at all, meaning you'll have a time precision to only plus minus 15 seconds every single month, which is great for quads, but something to think about as well if you really want precise timekeeping. At number 17 right now, this watch operates on two piece of CR927 lithium ion battery, which means when the battery runs out, you're gonna need to buy two batteries instead of one battery, so that is cost and effective to you. We're looking at number 18 already. The bezel is out of proportion to the inner watch face. I kind of agree with that. It is quite big for a watch this way. They could make the watch face bigger and the bezel thinner because the hard case is made out of carbon. We don't need thick bezel like this anymore. At number 19, this is from my own personal experience. It is really, look at that, smooth. There are no texture down here. Same goes with this part. It feels really, really smooth. Meaning, when you wear the watch throughout the day, if you sweat, the wrist gonna feel really, really weird, really, really odd. Same applies with this watch as well. It feels, feels really, really odd. It feels uncomfortable, I would say, because they didn't add any texture down at the watch band. It's just not for me. Last but not least is number 20, where the hands has no lume, but that it only applies to two models, that is the black and yellow and black and blue. So before you make your purchase, check the hands if you need the lume or not. This watch has the lume on the hour and the minute hand, but the other two didn't, so be very aware. That sums up all 20 reasons why you shouldn't buy the watch. A quick disclaimer though, this not just apply to this watch, a lot of other G-Shock watch at the same price range does have similar disadvantages. But I'm just gonna mention about the watch because it is popular, it is new, and well, you guys listen them out. And I'm quite surprised of how creative people could get just to think about the thing that could hate about a G-Shock watch. I mean, 20 reasons, that is a lot of reasons, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, that should sum it all. I'm gonna need to pack the watch, send this one away to the winner of the recent giveaway I made. Stay tuned for the next giveaway, which will be announced soon. For now, thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your comments. This is Jesh F, and I'm out.